All right, welcome everybody. Great to see you all. Gonna myself in gallery. See you all. Hey, wow, you came. Great to see you. just taking a moment to appreciate everybody. I'm especially appreciating that Fran has discovered the anti-gravity setting. And your screen. I can't work out how to undo my upside downness. Well, the thing is, maybe we're all upside down, Fran, and you are right side up. You're all right. So just a reminder that, this session, we're just the time to really, the theme is about ending well. Really honoring the time we spent together and leaving us with the abundant hearts. Yeah, it's filling up our cups with love here before we go. So the session is being recorded. If at any time you do not want to be on this gallery screen, you can turn your camera off. Before we spotlight you, we'll try to be mindful to ask, but I don't expect that much. Oh, there might be a little bit of that happening tonight. So yeah, if that's up, we'll ask you first. And then if we could post just a final reminder that this Padlet that, as Gita says, is bursting at the seams with gems. Just a reminder that there's places there for you to share freely. It's ours. The Padlet is ours. Fran Diaketu is sending you a tech helpline there in chat. But I'm fine with you. I'm fine with you being the way you are. And just to say, it's a refreshing reminder about perspective. But also, if you want to do something, Diaketu sent some help to you. And we have some resources after the retreat ends. There's also the website where all the recordings will live. And there's some additional resources there. For example, someone asked for a recording of a stupa practice. I think that one of those has been uploaded on the website, so you can check that out. Okay, just to say a little bit about what we're gonna do, and then I'm gonna pass over to Diaketu for a moment. But the program for tonight, we'll do a little arriving practice in a moment. And really we have some time for rejoicing. And then we'll have a closing ritual, simple ritual. And the last 10 minutes is a dance party. Maybe Singhasri can say a little bit more about that right before we get there. But obviously, it's a little self-explanatory, isn't it? Dance party. But just to say, to be very inclusive, that dancing includes everything from swaying to full on like busting out some moves you didn't even know you had in you. So all welcome. Yeah. All right. So Diaketu. Oh, and I should also give a warm welcome to Chandra Das, actually, while we're saying hi to our TBCO Buddhist Center Online folks. Chandra Das, hey, who helped scheme and dream this whole thing from the beginning. Such a generous collaborator. Do you want to say anything to the group before you go over Diaketu, Chandradasa?
I'll probably say something a little bit after Diaketu, but it's just really lovely to make it back in time to come to the last session. So I'm really glad I could come and just, it was really great looking at the Padlet and just seeing the life of the retreat. It's so obvious. It's just like, it's very beautiful. So I was just really thrilled, actually. So thanks for having me in your last session, even though I've not been part of your retreat.
Well, thank you for giving me these minutes. Very, very great to talk. Well, I know that there will be some closing later, but I think this is some minutes that I requested the team to basically thank everyone here. I wanted first to thank the team, my colleagues, Dharma Chakra team and the Buddhist Center Online. Actually, it's a lot of work that it's been put in events like this, for the booking system, to the promotions, to make things work smoothly. So I wanted to thank, for example, Zach, Chandradas also here, and also the tech team that put up together the platform for us to connect and to engage through there. And also rejoicing very quickly, or thanking actually Singeshri, Viveka, Balajit for their generosity. I have been being like a witness of this retreat, how everyone has been engaging, opening up basically to people in here. So I wanted to thank them on sharing their expertise. Sorry, I'm not very articulate today because I'm really tired. So I hope that you pardon my rusty English. But also I wanted to thank everyone in here. So I wanted to see if you can actually go into gallery view. I'm going to, if you can go into gallery view, I just want for you to go in there and see everyone and get a glance of everyone in here. Basically, I wanted to thank you all for being here. Personally, this is a big inspiration on seeing so many faces here on our events, engaging and talking and asking questions. And I don't know, being here, it's a great thing. And basically, this is what we want. We want to have an online sangha, an online community, something that is supportive, that is friendship friendly, that has companionship, basically, whenever you go into breakout rooms. I have not been going into breakout rooms because I have to make sure that everything is held up together. But I can see whenever you return, your faces, that you are happy, that you are inspired. And basically, this is not possible without you. So I also wanted to thank you. On this sense of giving you or being thankful and grateful for this, this is the objective that we want. No, so we do this on a dana basis. Basically, we don't have a specific amount for people to give something to join. So we are giving it openly so that people just join and benefit from wonderful teachings like Viveka, Balajit, Singeshri. But also there is a reality that resources are needed for this to be up and running. I just wanted to mention to you, if you are in a position, in a financial position to support us, please do. I know that many of you have been already very generous and giving donations in Eventbrite. But if you have the possibility to do that, I'm going to paste a link here. So that's it for me. Thanking you more than the donations. I think that for me, it's very important having these spaces, because basically it's the Dharma that it's flowing through us, you know, in a way, in this community. Even if it's only for a retreat, even if it's what I was saying to the team before, is that even that we are not physically in the same place, we feel that we are very close together, or at least that's how I feel. So I hope that you feel like that as well, and this helps you in your inspiration and practice. Thank you very much for listening, and I pass it on back to Viveka, Singeshri, or Balajit, I don't know.
Chandradas, so did you want to say anything more now? Or
if that's okay, I'll say something just for a couple of minutes. First of all, I really want to thank Daiketu and Zach, just double thanks. I've done quite a lot of these retreats online, and they are tons of work. I mean, however much work you think it is, it's more work than that. And Daiketu just has been tireless, so has Zach. And all the work behind the scenes after the sessions to get the videos ready, to get all the resources ready, just to kind of keep it all flowing so everybody can just have an enjoyable retreat, all the communication behind the scenes. So just sadhu, Daiketu, it's your first one flying solo, and you've just been amazing. I've had lots of stories since I came back of how good you've been. So well done. I just got back from Tokyo a few days ago, so I'm totally jet lagged. And it was really amazing meeting the Tokyo Sangha, and we spent a day sort of practicing together. And it was really moving at the end, because when they were going around doing their sort of gratitude circle, Susanna, who runs the group, was saying, without the Buddhist Center Online and Free Buddhist Audio, she wouldn't be practicing. There would be no Sangha in Tokyo. And she really meant it. It was kind of, often people say nice things about your work because you're there, you know, but like, she really meant it. She was saying, like, this is my Sangha. There's nobody near. And it was just really lovely to hear. And you know, we've only been doing this kind of thing for a few years. It seems like forever, but we've been doing these live retreats now for 3 years. And doing them at the start was difficult because there weren't very many of us. Being able to afford to employ somebody as amazing as Daiketu in Mexico City, but being able to have a team that's international like that, it takes a lot of work and it takes money. So if you've got the resources now or at any point in the future to support us, please do, because not only does it build teams to work for the Dharma, but it supports people like Susanna in Tokyo just to, you know, form groups of friends who've realized they want to put the Dharma at the center of their lives. And they're really supported by this kind of network. They're having the experience that you've had all week on this beautiful retreat. So thanks so much for your ongoing love and generosity. And yeah, finally, just thanks to the retreat team. I'm going to shout out to Singhasri in particular, because we started talking about this ages ago, and it's so beautiful to see it come to fruition. So well done, Sandhu.
Thank you. So we're just going to take a moment just to a little arriving practice. Just remembering we have so many things in our toolkit now. I found myself just doing the rubbing of the tops of the legs as a way to say hello as we come in. Breathing while we do that. And yeah, let's put an intention of loving kindness and maybe room for joy, and any other emotions that may be flowing. Just putting a hand on the heart and on the belly just for a moment. Just have a minute here. You can notice what it's like to do this with your eyes closed and coming deep within the inner space to start. Notice what it might be like with awareness to open the eyes and stay connected to your own core organs, your core. Not lose yourself as you come into relationship with, you see with your eyes, who you see with your eyes. Being here with each other, hand on heart, hand on belly. So we're going to keep rolling with this gratitude energy. And since we've been rejoicing a bit and really becoming aware of what it takes for the Buddhist Center Online team to make these retreats possible. The retreat leaders team also wanted to offer an appreciation. Yeah, to round that out a bit. So Balajit is going to share something on behalf of the retreat. And if anybody else wants to chat, I think that we're already seeing lots of appreciations in the chat. Please go ahead and add more love in the chat for our Buddhist Center Online team.
Yeah, thank you, Viveka. Yeah, I'm really pleased to have the opportunity to do this because I've been feeling kind of growing amounts of gratitude actually to the Buddhist Center Online team. And it started when we recorded the podcast. Some of you might have heard the podcast that we did some weeks before here, and we met with Chandradasa, and we had a kind of conversation that went on for quite some time and was quite sort of stop and start. And I thought, oh my goodness, what's that going to sound like on a podcast? And then miraculously, some days later, it was this flowing kind of conversation. And apparently Zach had spent just under 12 hours cutting and splicing and editing and such. And that for me, that was the start, really, of just realizing that my whole experience, and I think the whole team's experience of Buddhist Center Online, has been a really high standard of professionalism, you know, just very well organized and hardworking behind the scenes on the retreat. But it's been a lot more than hard work, because I mean, the tech team, and we're blessed to have Diakata with us, you know, on a number of our sessions, and also Zach, and then Stephen appeared, and Apeksha Priya, and Sangadara, people in different parts of the world. But there was consistently just like a lot of warmth, you know, a lot of creativity, and just this real willingness to support us as much as they could, for us to, you know, support you guys so much. So it's felt like the leaders, the teaching team, have been kind of holding the retreat, but then we've all been held by this wider kind of holding, you know, by the tech team themselves, that I think has made such a difference. And just in the very first meeting on this retreat with Diakata, when we first opened up the room, and the Diakata's eyes were wandering a bit behind me. And, you know, he just noticed that there was something in the corner of my room that wasn't quite the right kind of spirit for the retreat. So I just thought, wow, there's a real attention to detail here, you know. So, thank you, you know, on a real heart level to the tech team and everything they've offered, really. Yeah.
You got people wondering what was in the background. Yeah. So maybe we can also flash some loving emojis or whatever other gestures to let the team know we appreciate you. Yeah. All right. Just basking in the glow of that. Yeah. So it feels there's a ritual, a bit of a ritual on as we close retreats, to be able to offer some appreciation of also the teachers. And well, we were saying it's really awkward to be facilitating this for ourselves, but in a way it's also I feel it's a very positive thing to allow for expressions of gratitude. And we do want to get to a ritual as well. And at this point in the retreat, you know, gratitude can get expansive. There's already a lot in the Padlet, so that's another place to put it. So we're going to attempt to do this in 10 minutes. We'll see how that goes. And we've actually asked a couple people to rejoice in each of the three teachers for just like a minute or two. Yeah, there's no way to say all the wonderful things about each person. So we'll just, something that you want to share from the heart, the heart of the heart, and from the heart for a minute or two. So we're going to start with rejoicing in Singhasri. It's easy to do. Continue the rejoicing in Singhasri. And I'll just say a couple words, and then Gita and Maitrinita. Are you okay with going on spotlight, Gita and Maitrinita?
Yes, Maitrinita.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, I'm good.
All right. And just so we know, the answer is I prefer to stay in the gallery is also good too, if anybody wants. Yeah. Okay, so Singhasri, I have known Singhasri for since Singhasri was pre-Singhasri, not quite a baby, fully grown adult, but maybe an earlier version. And yeah, there's such joy in for me in just being able to join you and experience how the Dharma is growing and showing and being shared through you. And I want to especially appreciate your sensitivity to people, like your real care and emotional skillfulness with people. Really so sincere. You know, it's not like a thing you're doing to people, but just really, I feel so sincere and authentic. And then just your real passion and curiosity for the Dharma and just the way you're curating and what will be the most useful, you know, at a particular time as the moment emerges, and also the bigger body of teaching that you do keep growing. Yeah, the roots of what you're teaching. So I just feel like we're very lucky to have someone who's so conscious about teaching, so skilled and creative, and a very deep practitioner themselves. So sadhu, friend. So over to Gita.
Yeah, thank you. This is really lovely to be able to do this. Yeah, when I think of you, Singhasri, I just think of all the gifts that you've given me outside of this retreat and on this retreat and all of us. You know, so many qualities. Your energy in pursuit of the good, this boundless energy, which is really thoughtful and considerate and very nuanced, lots of pointing too, which I love and I'm grateful for. And yeah, and the pauses. Yeah, I really, really respect, that sensitivity to, like, you know, yeah, can we just pause? Yeah, your kindness and yeah, your generosity, it's just very abundant. And I kind of have a sense of you, like your beauty, like, really shines from within, like, really does. Like, I think, you know, day two or something, I was like looking at you, I was like thinking, oh my gosh, you're like glowing. And it comes from deep within. And I'm just really just honored to know you and, you know, to rub up against you. And I respect all that effort and time it must have taken and will still continue to take to be who you are. So you're just a big bundle of gifts, and you're funny. I have to say this, you're funny. You've got a great sense of humor and you laugh, you properly laugh. And that's such a great example and a reminder. So I just want to say thank you. You're just, yeah, giving it all out all the time. And I respect that.
Thanks, Gita. And Maitrinita.
Hello, Singhasri. So I've known Singhasri for probably just over 2-3 years now, mostly online. 3 years, yeah. And I just feel that she's such a kind of satellite for, that virya, the energy in pursuit of the good. That's the depth of that. I think that's really captured in what else is possible. What else is possible? That's your question at the end. And I think that's there in your perspective on, you know, just how you, you know, make questions, you know, respond to my questions and with a depth that feels like it takes in more than this world, but also goes into the roots of who I am, the roots of who we are. And I just felt like, you know, that Walt Whitman quote, which I love saying, and I think it's for you, it's around, when I give myself. And I really feel that is more and more what I see and witness from you. Yeah. And it's so wonderful to be around. So thank you. Thank you.
There's more in chat. We're not going to read every post, but I'm certainly we'll have time to scan through this. Yeah, I'm sure the Buddhist Center online can find a way to share the chat with us. So see if we can take it in. So as you're ready, Singhasri, you can keep the rejoicing party going.
Okay, thank you. So it's very hard to do this after all that. So I'm just taking deep breaths here. There should be like a big caution sign over. If you're going to do a retreat on opening up to the emotional body, then be ready to, for the rejoicings to just go right in all the way. Ooh. Yeah, so I have the great privilege to rejoice in Balajit and invite a few other folks to rejoice in Balajit. Balajit. I've been saying, Balajit recently let a whole group of people know that the way he pronounced his name is Balajit, and I had not known that, and I've been friends with him for 11 years. So that is goes to show you what a kind and gentle man Balajit is, because he's never corrected me. I'm just so grateful to you. For your deep, deep practice, how you just keep going. And, you know, this exploration of the body and where we're stuck in the body and where we're numb in the body and what it's like when all that starts to open and the ickiness and the messiness of that. This is really effing hard work. This is not the path of, you know, thinking our way to enlightenment. This is, you know, this is really, really hard work. It's not for the lighthearted. So I just really want to rejoice in that, actually, the fact that you, in recognizing your own places of stuckness, you were just totally up for it and you've gone there. And I have seen you particularly, I have to say, in the last year, you've really, really changed. And I'm like, I think I said this on the last retreat we were on. It occurred to me on that retreat, like, oh, I better keep going. Otherwise, Balajit's going to get too far ahead of me and I'm not going to be able to keep up. Not that we're in any kind of a competition, but yeah, just so appreciate being right side by side with you. Yeah, on our journeys, just and trading notes all the time. It's wonderful. What a delight. So I'm going to stop talking now. And pass over to Judica, who wanted to. Did I say your name right, Judica?
Yeah. Lovely. Well, it's lovely. Where's he gone? Oh, there he is. To be able to rejoice in you, Balajit. Because we were around the MBC together, and I suppose I've been alongside you for some of your journey into embodied practice. And I suppose because we haven't seen each other for a few years, when I did see you teaching, I was like, oh my, you know, like the practice has really borne fruit. And that was really obvious. And I feel like you've been very generous sharing that fruit with us. You know, all the knowledge, all the training you've done and all the practice you've done on yourself. Yeah, my favorite one I'm going to take away is, I think it's this one, because you can do that in the supermarket or anywhere and nobody will think you're that strange. But you've shared yourself as well, and you've really shared your own process, and you've been really vulnerable and open and emotional. And I really felt the retreat sort of chunked down when you were like that, and it was like permission to all of us to go there, really. And you know, we could be vulnerable, we can be open. And I think that's a huge leap of trust, you know, when you can't physically be in the room with everyone, that you did that. So yeah, I really appreciate that. And there's another side of you that, you know, when you said like you focus more on the bricks than the kites, I suppose to me you have a lightness of being really, and that is in your sort of sense of humor, maybe a little bit mischievous. I was thinking even a rogue qualities there that I've always enjoyed, and you know, that comes across in your teaching, and I think that helps us go into difficult areas to have that combination of lightness and depth. Yeah, and my strongest memory of you is on a ritual in Vajrasattva where you led us into the forest on the old moon, and we picked the spot for the ritual, but Balajit kept going and found another spot that was actually even better. It was a lot of old trees that had died and the ritual was to the crown. So I thought, oh yeah, there's a sort of fool, you know, the crazy wisdom of the fool, that that's there as well. And that takes us to unknown places. So I wanted to rejoice in that as well. And yeah, so big thank you.
Thank you so much, Viveka. That was beautiful. I hope you're still breathing over there, Balajit. Balajit, oh my God. 10 years.
Just about.
Okay. And I want to invite Saravantu to unmute herself and bring herself in to rejoice in Balajit.
Thank you. Very happy to do that. I also wanted to rejoice in your commitment to the brick. When you shared that, I just thought, oh, something in my body feels safe with you, because you are really willing to engage with whatever is in the shadow and the brick and, you know, the tricky stuff. And yeah, that's been fantastic for me. The main quality that came to my mind was kindness and a kind of meeting of experience of whatever arises, whatever we bring, with such kindness. And I just thought, oh, that is the fruit, I imagine, of a lot of work, of you meeting whatever arises in yourself with kindness, of really practicing being with your own inner young parts, and getting more and more skilled over the years at greeting them with kindness. And wow, is that bearing fruit, I think, in your what feels just a very genuine capacity to meet the rest of us with that kindness. I loved your puppets, and I thought, oh, there's something there about just a willingness to risk looking foolish, which I really salute. And I think you never have looked foolish because of that, because there's just a kind of willingness to be who you are, to offer all these things which, you know, will be helpful in different ways for people. And I just feel like you model quite a few, you kind of manifest quite a few very important qualities that I feel like I don't often see manifesting in a white man. Something about that vulnerability, that authenticity, humility, that just kind of willingness to, I don't know, drop the kind of, you know, the pride of wanting to look good and just be spontaneously what's coming up. I've loved that. And although, you know, but there's this combination of obviously you've shared your griefs with us. And at the same time, I feel like there's a sense in you of like laughter and a smile being kind of near and available and kind of bubbling up. And that's been a real joy, that sense of kind of delight that just kind of bubbles, you know, doesn't need that much to call it forth. It's just ready to be joyful at life. So thank you for all you've shared on the retreat, and I hope it's not long before I get to see you in person again. Sadhu Balajit.
Oh, thank you so much, Saravantu. Well said. So Balajit. I'm going to have to practice. Over to you when you're ready. Maybe take a few breaths.
I might need a few more than a few breaths, actually. heartfelt gratitude. I mean, yeah, Jitika, I've known for so long. And so, yeah, a big part of my life in Manchester and things. And, yes, yeah, Saravantu, I've known for many years. So thank you both for that. So, Viveka, yeah. So, just three main things I'd just like to say with Viveka. I don't know Viveka very well. I feel the main way I know Viveka was through Singha Sri, you know, knowing what a big figure in Singha Sri's life Viveka has been. One of the things that's really struck me I've just seen time and time again on this retreat is your clarity in complexity, you know, your clarity in complexity in all sorts of different ways, you know, whether it's planning the program for the retreat or just in general conversation or in your teaching, you know, there's this real kind of Vajra kind of clarity somehow cutting through that, you know. Another dimension is that you've clearly got a lot of depth of practice within you, you know awareness of your being, like somatically, but at the same time you've got very strong skills relationally, you know, and I just really deeply admire that capacity to have a depth and sensitivity of somatic awareness, but at the same time to be so skilled and kind and compassionate relationally, you know, relationally. So that's quite a spectrum to kind of cover, really. And then finally, it seems like you've got this kind of spring of joy that just keeps coming up and animates your being, really. It's like your eyes kind of sparkle and you smile and things. And you just seem like a kind of, particularly with those movement exercises, like this kind of sparkly, cheeky, grinning darkening. You know, and had a really big effect on me. Someone completely freely being themselves, you know, just that free life force just flowing without limit. So yeah, I could go on, but I won't. I'm going to do this a little bit differently tonight, because I know the Viveka speaks a lot about trusting emergence and trusting spontaneity. So Mumukshu has kindly agreed to speak. But firstly, I'm just wondering if someone from the retreat would just like to pop their hand up now and just have a few minutes just to spontaneously say some things in praise for Viveka.
I can say something.
Thank you, Alan.
Viveka, I've never met you before. You're an amazing Dharma teacher. You remind me of a jazz musician. So playing the Dharma saxophone. When I first heard you starting off your teaching at the beginning of the retreat, I thought, what is she going on about? And then I sort of rested back and it just flowed. And it just connected with me on a very deep level. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart for your teaching. And I hope to come across you again. Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Alan. Thank you for stepping into the space of spontaneity there. And now, yeah, I'd like to invite Mumukshu to rejoice in Viveka.
No, I can leave that there. No. What have I got to do? Oh, there. Sorry. Two different ways to unmute myself. Yeah, I'm really feeling the anxiety in my body in ways that I might a week ago have completely ignored, but I'm more conscious. So I feel really privileged to be able to be the one that rejoices in you on behalf of everybody else. For me, you are the warmest, funniest, friendliest, and wisest person I probably know. In fact, definitely, I think. I've always been so impressed with how you can engage so wholeheartedly with in like a genuinely really heartfelt way with anybody, meeting them wherever they need to be met on whatever, however they need to be met, as you've shown on this retreat again and again. But also I know, aware of how much work you also, how much of yourself you give out so much more widely as well in the areas where this resourcing is so needed, your passion for working with injustice and resourcing people to deal with whatever battles they're in or the ways in which they wish to change the world. You just give of yourself so freely and fully. And we've received so much of that on this retreat as well. And at the same time, you're able to do all that with such lightness and humor. That just makes us able to receive more more easily in a way. And I've been so moved. I am having to look at my notes a bit, because once I'm kind of in the spotlight, as it were, part of my brain disappears. As Valajit was kindly explaining how that happens. Yes, I've been so moved, as I'm sure everybody else has on the retreat, with all the kindness and care, and others have already mentioned this, that you've shown throughout, that real wanting us to be resourced and feel safe and have everything we need, so that we can really, and to learn how to do that for ourselves, so that we can really sort of open to receive the depth and breadth of the wisdom teachings that you've shared without holding back or dialing down, or, you know, really strong stuff, really, the passion for, the example of, you know, encouraging us to be able, wherever we are at, finding ways to do to flash into the open dimension. Fantastic. So much generosity and trust that shows. And for me, your teachings have been life-changing in many ways, from the introduction to pure awareness many years ago on a order convention. I was really, I'd met you earlier, very soon after I'd been ordained, so that's about 20 years ago, when you were
Yeah, I'll come back to that bit. So yeah, I felt you really extended the hand of friendship to me in such a generous way. And then because I was overawed by the teachings, by your wisdom and my shyness and easily becoming overwhelmed and so on, I felt I really held back. And now it feels, after being on retreats with you and now working together at Akashavana, and feeling I was in the support team, but I felt just so totally supported by you all the time. And Singha Shri, you know, we were supporting you guys, but we just got so much, so much from you. And those were great retreats. So I kind of feel like your persistence, in a way, your kind persistence with me and the help of all the teachings I've received from me has really, you know, has worked some kind of magic in many, many ways, changing my life and my habitual self-view and so on. So I feel I can really, really call you friend, and that makes me very, very happy. Yeah. Thank you very, very much.
So we have a curious pause there. I think all three of us were looking at each other. So let's, I'm going to pass over to Singha Shri, actually.
Nice one. Thanks, Bajit. Oh my God. Okay. Thank you so much to all of the voices of the retreat and all of the wonderful words in the chat. So for those of you who don't know, I'll just give you a little quick tutorial on how to save the chat, because you might want to go back to it later. So if you open your chat box, there's three little dots sort of in the middle at the bottom. And if you click on that, the very first choice in the drop-down menu is Save Chat. And on that note, we're going to have a 5-minute leg stretch before our ritual. So so just 5 minutes to stretch, get some water, go to the loo, grab that soft toy that you left in your bedroom or whatever else you need to do to get ready for our closing ritual. Okay, friends. So before we get into this ritual, I'm going to just take the opportunity, since I'm holding the space, to say a deep appreciation to Chandradasa for being so open to my ideas and helping me cook up this idea. And then, to Balaji and Viveka for answering the call to come and join us in this beautiful offering. So I'm just like really, really moved right now by what can happen when we all come together and bring our energy together, and just how much, just the mutuality of what's here. It's really beautiful. So we're gonna have this closing ritual. So I'll just say a bit about the running order of things, and then we shall do it. It will happen, it will manifest. So we're going to start with a 10-minute sit, just to settle a bit after the ebullience, that's the right word, and just really let ourselves, you know, we've been doing this throughout the retreat, absorb the benefits of the retreat, simmer in the deliciousness of the rejoicings, and just, be with what's here now. Let it all in, however it is. Maybe there's some grief mixed up with delight, mixed up with a bit of confusion, excitement. So whatever's here, for 10 minutes. And at the start of that sit, Alyssa has a poem that she wants to offer to the retreat. So Alyssa, when we begin the sit, what I'll do is I'll ring a bell and then you can read the poem. Yeah. And then we'll just sit for 10 minutes. And then there'll be a short period of reflection just to reflect on our intentions going forward from this retreat. Yeah, just how you want to keep going, what qualities you think you need, what questions you're holding, how you'd like to show up for the next phase of your practice in your life. And then we'll have a version of the Vajrasattva mantra by the beautiful Tibetan singer Drukmo Gyal. And during the mantra, please feel free to make offerings to your at-home shrine and to offer your intentions in the chat or on the Padlet. And then something else will happen. Bear with me, I've got too many things on my screen. Yeah, and then we will do the transference of merit verses from the Sevenfold Puja. Is there someone who would be happy to be the voice of the retreat for the transference? Chittamodini, is that you waving to say that you'll be the voice of the retreat? Fantastic. I'm glad you were on the first screen. And then we will do three hearty sadhus. And in service of chaos, we will all take ourselves off mute for those three sadhus, because in a way it doesn't matter. And hopefully we won't blow Zoom server somewhere in Texas. Okay, and then the moment you've all been waiting for, we'll have the dance party. All right, so let's just settle for a moment and take a few deep breaths. Find our seat. Laying down is also always an option.
Ach, nicht getrennt sein, nicht durch so wenig Wandung ausgeschlossen vom Sternenmaß. Inneres, was ist's, wenn nicht gesteigerter Himmel, durchworfen mit Vögeln und tief von Winden der Heimkehr. Oh, not to be separated, shut off from the starry dimensions by so thin a wall. What is within us, if not intensified sky, traversed with birds, and deep with winds of homecoming?
So a short sit to absorb a retreat. taking a couple of minutes just to reflect on any intentions we'd like to carry with us. Taking the fruits of the retreat into our daily lives, the rest of our lives. Transference of merit and self-surrender.
May the merit gained.
In my acting thus.
Go to the alleviation of the suffering of all beings.
My personality throughout my existences. My possessions. And my merit in all three ways. I give up without regard to myself. For the benefit of all beings. Just as the earth and other elements. Are serviceable in many ways. To the infinite number of beings. Inhabiting limitless space. So may I become. That which maintains all beings.
Situated throughout space.
So long as all have not attained. To peace. So everyone unmute yourselves. Take in a deep breath together.
Sadhu.
I can't.